Hi and welcome to this video. In this video, let's see how you can use the compressor in Audacity. So we are going to see how you can work with this compressor, and I have the perfect audio that is going to show us how to work with compressor in Audacity. So this is an audio for a tutorial that I did, and somewhere along the journey, somewhere around here, I might have clicked on something that affected the volume of my recording. And so we're going to see how we can compress the audio so that this part and this part can at least match, okay? So just to show you the compressor in Audacity, if I just click here to select the entire audio, you can see the compressor. This is how the compressor is, and which version of Audacity is this? I'm using version 2.32, and this is not the latest version, but I hope the compressor hasn't changed, and it still looks like this. So just follow along with me and you're going to see how you can compress your audio so that you can try to level it correctly. So the first thing, if you look at this compressor settings, you're going to need a threshold, and the noise floor, we can leave that, and then the ratio. So this is the one that most people usually don't know. How can I get this threshold? So if you look at this, let me just choose the highest point of my audio here. The lowest point actually of my audio is on this side, right? So if I want to find that point above which I need to compress my audio, I'll need to find it on this point, on this side of my audio where the audio is low. So what is compression? Compression is basically just trying to lower the high gains. So these parts which are very high, we'll need to lower them. That is what compression is. And then once you compress the audio, you can amplify it. And we're going to do that as well later. So here, let me increase this so that I can see the wave somewhere around here. And if I try to play this, you can hear that it's very low, but I want to get the decibel level for this. And for me to get the level, I can check here. So we're going to see the highest point, which is brute for us here. So the highest point is going to help us know the highest level for our audio, and we're going to use that as a level for our compression. So let me just listen once again, and I'm going to keep my eye on this to see the highest level for my audio. So I can see that the highest point for me is negative 42 decibels, and you can tell that's a very low audio. I'm going to have to come to the compression effect, go into compressor, and I have to lower this all the way down to about that value of, let me just do it at 44, and at the same time the noise level, I need to reduce this because I don't want it to affect the low levels of my audio. So let me reduce that further, and then as for compression, I can just leave it at 3.1, but you can always go to 2.1. so the higher you go, the more it gets compressed. So I'm just going to do something like 2. So let me try and see what this is going to do for me. And you can preview, you can see that I haven't checked this, so yours is probably checked. And check that, because you're going to do the gain, we're going to make up for the gain later on, not now. So let me say okay and just see what's going to happen. Let's give it time to compress the audio so that you can see how this part and this part are going to match once the compression is done. So once the compression is complete, you can see that it has tried as much as possible just to make the compression on this side and this side match. So you can see that Audacity has really tried, okay? This part is still pretty bad, you can see, but Audacity has tried as much as it can to make sure that this part and this part are almost equal. So the first thing I'm going to do again is I'm going to normalize this audio, and to normalize is basically just amplifying. So I'm going to amplify it using normalization because I don't want to work with Audacity's amplification while I can just do it as fast using normalize. So I will normalize it to negative 3 decibels, and you're going to see how that is going to affect our audio. So once I normalize it, you can see that the audio has been raised. Let's go all this side, and this side you can see it's been raised as well. And this side is still pretty high as compared, it's still pretty loud as compared to this other part. So let's see the difference. And I'm going to drag in this audio inside of Audacity. So first, I will open Audacity. And let's listen to this other part. And when I open Audacity, I can just drag in my audio inside here. And the first thing I want to do is I want to increase the tempo of the audio. So at this point, I've just come to accept that my audio quality is going to be slightly lower. It's going to be slightly bad, and therefore I'm just trying to salvage it as much as I can. So I'm going to try and do another round of compression, and then I'm going to normalize it once again. So I'll select the entire audio, and then I'll come here. And let me just first of all find out the highest, the level and of this. When I open Audacity, I can see that the highest is at about 19. So I can just do that and come back into compression. And I want to try and match this and this. So I can take it down. Let me just take it down up to about 25, right? Remember, this side was 25. And we can also just increase that. Let me leave it at 55. And the ratio, I'll just leave it at 3.1. And I'll try to compress once again. And when I compress, this is what I get. Okay. And when I open Audacity, and you can even do another round of compression just to try to get them to match. But I'm just going to leave it at this point because I don't want to affect the audio quality too much, because the more you compress, it will just affect the audio quality even more. So let's just say that once we reach this point, the audio is going to go lower, and I can come back and normalize once again, and I will normalize it to negative 3 decibels. Now, if you look at this and you look at the original audio, you're going to see that there is definitely improvement in terms of the audio consistency. Initially, it was very low, and now at least it's not at the same level as this, but you can see that there is a difference as compared to how it was initially. So that's how compression can help you. Another alternative would have been for me to amplify this to a certain level, and amplify this to a certain level so that the two could match, but I'm trying to match them just as they are using compression. So that's one way that compression can help you to get your audio quality to be slightly much better in case there is some parity in the audio when you're recording. So for me, the mistake was the microphone recording volume went down at a certain point here. At least using the Audacity compression, I've been able to bring some consistency using compression and just normalizing the audio. So it will not be as perfect as it would have been if the audio would have been consistent throughout, but this is still a better alternative than having to just normalize the audio without compressing it. So in this video, you've seen how you can compress your audio and just use the same skills to make your audio better in compression. Just note that the more you compress the audio, of course, the sound quality will also deteriorate. So you're just better off recording good quality sound, and then you do a bit of compression, and then you can amplify it, and that will give you a much better audio quality. So if you have any questions, feel free to let me know, and I will see you next time.